Amid allegations of being a favored contractor under the administration, the owner of City Leoncio Trading and Construction appears before the House Committee on Rules. The firm supposedly cornered multiple projects in Sorsogon and Catanduanes worth 1.6 billion pesos in 2018 alone. Owner Consolacion Leoncio denies personally knowing Budget Secretary Benjamin Diokno, but admitted entering into a joint venture agreement with Arimar Construction Corp. Documents presented at the hearing by Committee Chairman Rolando Andaya Jr. show among Arimar's incorporators are Diokno's son-in-law Romeo Sikat Jr. and his stepfather, Kasiguran Mayor Jose Edwin Hamor. Andaya further claimed that a third of City Leoncio's projects in Sorsogon, amounting to 551 million pesos, went to Arimar Construction in 2018.
Ito pong Arimar, binigyan nyo ng subcontract na half a billion peso. So, ano ho ang reason kung bakit pinabura ninyo ang Arimar?
Hindi ko po pinabura ninyo. Nag-baby po kami.
Nag-ano kayo?
Joint venture po.
What is the special relation?
Ang talaga pong nakakakilala dyan, yung pong liaison po na si Francis Clemente. Lumapit lang po ang Arimar at sinabi na kung pwede mag-baby kami.
Ordinaryo po bang masasabi na hindi nyo siya masyadong kakilala?
Minsan po kaming mag-JB at okay na po ang trabaho namin. Wala naman po akong doubt sa tao na yan.
City Leoncio also denied knowing Arimar's connection to Diokno before entering the joint venture agreement.
Oh, not necessarily true kasi CTL has been in vehicle with Johan for quite some time kahit wala pa naman sila Secretary Joclis.
But Andaya suspects City Leoncio is being used as Arimar's dummy as well as seven other contractors which the House Majority Leader hopes to name in the succeeding hearings.
Moro-moro lang daw ang nangyayari sa bidding. Sa ating kaso ngayon, lumalabas ng City Leoncio ang nanalo sa project, pero ang totoong may-ari ng proyekto ay ang Arimar.
Andaya estimates around 10 billion pesos in government projects went to Arimar in 2018. He presented a deposit slip showing a payment of 11.4 million pesos, supposedly by a winning bidder to Arimar. The committee will seek the assistance of the Anti-Money Laundering Council to look into the bank transactions of Arimar Construction and City Leoncio Construction. Also during the hearing, Andaya questioned the 14.5 billion pesos worth of flood control projects Diokno supposedly inserted in the proposed 2019 budget. He claims that DBM allocated bulk of the funds to areas that are not flood-prone.
May ilang contractors din na umamin. Ibinulugar nila ang flood control scam na nangyayari ngayon. Sa mga flood control projects daw, inilalagay ang park funds. Dahil daw, walang master plan ang DPWH.
Though invited, Diokno was a no-show at the hearing. ABS-CBN is still trying to get his side. He previously denied having a hand in the implementation of government projects and also denied using his influence to help corner contracts for the province where his in-laws are elected officials. The issue surfaced after Senator Lacson accused the districts of Andaya and House Speaker Arroyo of cornering billions of pesos in pork barrel funds in the 2019 proposed budget. The palace expressed confidence that Diokno will be able to answer the allegations thrown at him. It previously said that the DBM secretary continues to enjoy the trust and confidence of the president.
Oh, I'm sure, definitely, Secretary Diokno is very competent to respond to any question directed to him.
Andaya also said government's plan to implement a cash-based budgeting system this year will no longer push through. Among the reasons he cited are the unpaid delivered projects in 2018 amounting to around 30 billion pesos and the extension of the validity of the 2018 General Appropriations Act, which disrupt the cash-based budgeting system.
First reason, yung mga hindi pa nababayaran na contractor, nababayaran January. Ngayon na, where will you get the money? This year. This year, di kinain mo na yung budget ng 2019.
Under the cash-based system, the government may appropriate, bid out, complete, and pay projects within a single year. Diokno says the implementation of the cash-based budgeting system is still on beginning this year. The DBM is still consulting with line agencies on the impact of the extension of the 2018 budget to the 2019 cash budget. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News, Naga City.